I founded Prevention Institute almost 20 years ago with the goal that there would be a place developing effective strategies to keep people from getting sick or injured in the first place whenever possible. We do this work 24/7, and one thing we've learned is that in order to ensure individual health, we need to focus on the community environment. This is a time when a lot of people are thinking about health and healthcare, great opportunities really not only reconfigure, but really to reimagine health. It's critical then to redesign health in a way that pays attention to the community environment. So we're talking and thinking about this notion, community-centered health homes, as a breakthrough way to really enhance health for entire communities, to reshape the health of entire communities. Recently, I met a doctor. She asked me what I did, and when I told her, started to cry. No one cries about prevention. She explained to me that she had just been with a patient and needed to tell him that he had pretty severe diabetes. She, of course, gave him the medications he needed, emphasized how important it was to take them, and also encouraged him to walk more and to eat healthier food. When he closed the door, she said, I felt like a hypocrite, because he knew and I knew that given how late he worked and where he lived, that walking was not going to be possible, it just wasn't safe, and that there was no place to access healthier food. I felt powerless, she said. But doctors don't need to feel powerless. Healthcare has the credibility, healthcare has the knowledge, and healthcare has the motivation to really do something different. And that's what community-centered health is all about translating what's going on with an individual patient and saying, what are the community issues, the community determinants, and how can we have an impact there as well? Healthcare can strategize about what the issues are that lead to medical conditions and what changes can be made in the community environment, and they can work with partners to accomplish those changes. That's what's critical, using their credibility to accomplish those big changes. Let me give you an example from Oakland, California, near my office. In Chinatown there, the health clinic was seeing a number of people brought in because of car crashes, in many cases pedestrians. They talked about the fact that they needed to be more ready, needed to expand their capacity in the clinic for trauma. But then someone said, beyond the trauma, why don't we understand what's going on in the community that's leading to all these crashes? And they brought together community members, policymakers, traffic planners, health agency, and what they understood was not far away, there were streets where the traffic patterns were really chaotic and with lots of people and lots of cars. So what they did is they redesigned the traffic, and they had red lights first in one direction, then in another direction, and then they stopped all the cars and enabled the pedestrians to cross in whatever ways were necessary. This redesign has reduced the number of crashes, has reduced the number of incidents, has reduced the number of injuries. This is using a tool or an approach from Prevention Institute we call Two Steps to Prevention. We start with the medical condition, in this case the trauma, and we say, wait a minute, what were the behaviors? But then we take a second step, and we go back and say, what is the environment? And we see this chaotic environment. And we say, if we can stop the chaos of the environment by redesigning the traffic patterns, we'll have an impact not just on one person or one crash or one incident, but we'll have an impact on the entire set of community health. And a community-wide solution which emerged from the health provider understanding the issue. The community-centered health homes process was really designed to mirror the medical process. When we go to our healthcare provider, they ask us what we're experiencing, what the problem is that brought them there, and then they make an assessment of what the condition seems to be. And of course, most important to us, they then come up with a plan often it's medication or other forms of treatment. And what we're most interested in is, okay, what do we do? With community-centered health homes, the questions that are being asked and what's going on in the back of the mind of the healthcare provider is, what are the community conditions? And an assessment is made of what community conditions might be leading to the problem. And again, the most important thing is then taking action on those community conditions. We must build a movement to advance community health and prevention. We can save lives, we can save money, we can improve health and well-being, reduce illness and injury, but it requires the healthcare community to transform and to speak up. Einstein said that intellectuals solve problems, but geniuses prevent them. It doesn't take genius, it simply takes all of us creating a new way of thinking, community-centered health.